first job is executed is the shortest job first, so therefore it executes the P2 first. So it start executing the P2. So P2 is executed first. So P2 is executed first, followed by P3. Then last one is it is a P1. Okay. So P1 for the P2, the time taken to complete this P2 is it is a 5 millisecond. Hence it begins with the zero time, and within 5 millisecond this job is completed. Within 5 millisecond it completes its operation, because it is a non-primitive. Until and unless it complete its job, the processor is not at all taking the next process. Okay, then it is going to take the process called as a P2 completes. Next, it is going to take the next shortest job, that is a process. So it is a third process. Okay, so P3 is taken by the processor in order to execute. So P3 takes the 7 minutes to complete. Hence, total time to execute this P3 is, it is a 5 minutes it is waiting, and for the execution 7 minutes. So totally next 12 seconds it is going to complete. So the time taken to execute this is, it is a 7 millisecond. Whereas this for the P2, it is only 5 millisecond. P2 is 5 millisecond. P2 5 millisecond. This is 5 millisecond. Okay, so then it takes the P3 process, because P3 has the next less time taken. Therefore, the processor takes the process P3 for the execution. So it is going to complete at the 12 millisecond. Next, it is going to take the last job called as a P1. Last job called as a P1. So this is how it execute the programs in case of the shortest job first scheduling. Okay, I'll take the little bit complex problem, because it is a very simple in the case of the short job first. So let me take some little bit the complex one. Even it is a simple also. For example, you can take the simple one, complex one will take. Calculate waiting time and turnaround time for each process, and average waiting time and turnaround time. The process IDs are P1, P2, P3 with completion time as like a 10.57. So the completion times are 10.57. Three IDs, completion time is 10.57. Okay. Meanwhile, P4 with estimated completion time 2 milliseconds. So P4, this is a P1, P2, P3. So meanwhile, the P4 enter the ready queue. So after the completion time of 2 milliseconds, so 2 millisecond completion time, the ready queue after 2 milliseconds of P2, after 2 millisecond of P2, after 2 millisecond of, after 2 millisecond of P2. Now P2. So what you can do now, you have to find out the waiting time and turnaround time. for each process by using the concept called as a SJM. Okay, so as usual, the P2 begins first because it is a, the shortest completion time. Therefore, in this case also, the P2 begins first. P2 begins first, followed by some other jobs, some other processor. So P2 begins executing. So P2 begins executing. So it is going to complete after 5 milliseconds. So it is going to complete the time taken to completion also 5 milliseconds, as well as it is going to complete after 5 milliseconds. Okay. So this P4 enters the ready queue after this P2. After the P2. Okay. So P2 enters the ready queue at the zero time. Whereas while giving the service to the this P2, the P4 arrive to the ready queue. Okay, so when it is arrives after 2 milliseconds execution of the P2. So after 2 milliseconds execution of the P2, the P4 arrives, and its execution time is, or the completion time is, only 2 milliseconds. Hence, because it is a non-primitive. The until and unless the process is executed in the processor, the process is not going to take the next process. Okay, so after completion of the this P2, at the 5 milliseconds, P2 will be in the queue, then P3 will be in the queue, P2 will be in the queue. After 5 milliseconds, P2 will be in the queue, so P2 will be in the queue. Then we have the P3, then P1. Out of these three, so P2 has a the shortest completion time. Hence, so it is going to take, the processor is going to take the process called as a P4. Okay, because P4 has only 2 millisecond completion time. Hence, at the 7 milliseconds, the P4 is going to complete. So the remaining process in the ready queue is one is P1 and the other one is the P3. So out of these two, so P3 has the smallest completion time. Hence, next job taken by the processor is P3. Okay, so P3 it is a P3. So in order to execute the P3, the completion time for the P3 is a 7 milliseconds. Hence, it is going to complete its operation so at 14 milliseconds. It is going to complete its operation at 14 milliseconds. Next, it is going to take the job called as a P1. So P1 completion time is, it is totally 10 milliseconds. So therefore, the processor takes the job called as a P1. Is going to take the process called as a P1. So in order to complete, the completion time for the P1 is, it is a 10 milliseconds. Hence, it started at 14 and it is going to complete its operation at the 24 milliseconds. Okay, so by making use of this Gantt chart, what you can do, you can find out the average waiting time, as well as the average turnaround time, you can find out. So average waiting time is, you can find out the average waiting time. The waiting time for the P2, you know that the waiting time for the P2 is, so waiting time for the P2 is 0. Waiting time for P2 is equal to 0. The waiting time, okay, so you should be very careful while finding the waiting time for the, according to the Gantt chart, the next process is a P4. So while taking the waiting time of the P4, you should be very careful, because most of the students, so they do mistakes at choosing the waiting time of the P4. So the P4 arrived to the ready queue after P2, so 2 milliseconds, okay? 2 milliseconds after P2, okay? Hence, the waiting time, the P2 completes at 5 milliseconds. Therefore, this is the waiting time for the what you can call as a P4. Waiting time for the P4 is, it is a 3 millisecond. Waiting time for the P4 is 3 millisecond. Okay, so because it arrived to the ready queue 2 millisecond after P2. So P2 arrives at 0. Hence, the P4 arrived to the system or the ready queue. So 2 millisecond after the P2. Therefore, P2 completes in 5 millisecond. Hence, the P4 is waiting till this 5 millisecond. Hence, it arrives to the ready queue 2 millisecond after the P2. Therefore, waiting time for the P4 is, it is a 3 millisecond. So like that, waiting time. P4 is going to complete its operation in the next 2 minutes. Hence, the waiting time for the P3 is equal to, it is a 7 millisecond. Okay. So like that, waiting time for the P1 is, so waiting time for the P1 is, it is a 14 millisecond. Hence, the average waiting time of all the process, average waiting time of all the process is, you can easily calculate waiting time of all process, is equal to P1, waiting time of the P2, waiting time of the P4, waiting time of the P3 plus waiting time of the P1, dividing by 4 process arrive to the ready queue, therefore dividing by 4. So this is equal to, substitute the values, 0, P4 is 3 millisecond, so P3 is 7 millisecond, so it is a P1 is, it is a 14 millisecond. All together dividing by 4, all together is a 24 dividing by 4. So 24 dividing by 4, it is 6, huh? It is equal to 6. So the average waiting time is, it is a 6 millisecond. Like that, you can find out the turnaround time. Turnaround time for P1. So waiting time plus completion time. So turnaround time for the P1 is, so it is a 5 milliseconds. So P1 is, it is equal to 5 milliseconds. Okay, P1 is 5 millisecond. P4 is again, this also 5 millisecond. P4 is equal to 5 millisecond. So then P4 is 5 millisecond. So this is first one is P2. First one is P2, 5 millisecond. P4 is also 5 millisecond. So P4 is, waiting time for the P4 is, it is a 3 millisecond. Then completion time is, it is a 2 millisecond. Hence P4 also 5 millisecond. So like that, you can find out the turnaround time for the P3. Is equal to waiting time. Waiting time is, it is a 7 millisecond plus 7 milliseconds for the completion. So totally it is going to take turnaround time, it is a 14 millisecond. Like that, the P1 waiting time is 14 millisecond plus execution time is a 10 millisecond or completion time is a 10 millisecond. So all together is equal to 24 millisecond. Hence, the average turnaround time, is equal to sum of the average turnaround of the this all the process, average turnaround time, is equal to sum of the turnaround time of the all the process dividing by 4. So it is equal to, directly I'll substitute the 5 plus 5 plus 14 plus 24. So this is equal to 24 plus 24, it is equal to 48 dividing by 4. 48 dividing by 4. So this is equal to, so I think 12 millisecond. Average turnaround time for all these processes, it is equal to 12 millisecond. So this is how we calculate the average time as well as the turnaround time for the all the process in the case of the SJM.